All right, Shalom. It's the brother Yeshaya. The Lord put the spirit on me to do another lesson. I want to give all honor, praises, and glory. Kol Halayim, Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahweh Shah. Double honors to the elders and apostles of Great Millstone who rule well through the scriptures, man. And also peace, love, and salutations to the elect out there, man. The elect Akim and the men, women, and children that consist of the elect also, man. All right. Yeah, man. Okay, so I was watching the news the other day. Well, actually, it was on in the gym, and it was basically tracking Hurricane Irma and Jose. All right. And it was showing the track, and the Lord put the spirit on me, okay, to basically link up that the track where the storms are being, you know, brewed up in, so to say, or where they're being born, in a sense, all right, is the slave trade route, okay? As you can see on the screen, all right, this is the route of the slave trade, man. As we know, okay, through extensive research, mostly the spirit, but through extensive research, okay, going back to the milk, going back to the, you know, to the foundation of our knowledge, man. We knowing that we were in the land of Israel, okay, which is our homeland, but fleeing Roman persecution in 70 AD, we Israelites were forced to flee into Africa, okay? And most of us was on the West Coast, okay? Sierra Leone, the Senegal, the Congo, all right? Angola, you know? And from there, all right? We were put into slavery, okay, and put and taken on cargo slave ships to various parts of the Americas. All right, North America, Central America, and South America. Okay, and I'm gonna show and this is the storm tracker where the storms really get brewed up at. See, this Africa. And then there's Africa right here. You can barely see it. But the storms, they originate in the Atlantic right here from the west coast of Africa. And they come through and they hit various parts of North America, South America, Central America, man. You see? So it's a direct correlation of, you know what I'm saying? It's a direct correlation to the slave trade route, man. All right? And, you know, basically I said all that to say this, man. Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shah, who you inwardly call God of Jesus Christ, did not forget what you heathen nations did to the children of Israel, man. Slavery, okay? And y'all are gonna get repaid for that, all right? And look at this slave route right here. Just imagine, okay? The elect, which, you know, the Lord is only dealing with right now on this side, the elect were on these ships, man. All right? The bodies of the elect were thrown in this Atlantic Ocean, were getting raped on those ships, were suffering all type of cruelties on those ships, man. All right, the Lord has not forgotten about his elect, man. And I'm going to link that up in scripture. First off, I'm going to back this slave trade route. I mean, this slave trade picture up with scripture that we are the children of Israel. And we were put in the cargo slave ships and taken into, you know, various parts of the Americas to serve out our captivity, slavery. All right. This is the book of Deuteronomy, chapter 28, verse 68. And the Lord shall bring thee into Egypt again with ships. That's right. You look on the map. You can walk. It's landlocked. Egypt and Israel is landlocked. Okay. So you people, our forefathers and used to walk and travel. You know, not walk, but travel on camelback, and you know, from Israel to you know, various parts of Africa and Egypt. Okay. Yahweh Shah fled into Africa, okay, to hide out, all right, you know, but yeah, anyway, Egypt, this word Egypt means bondage or captivity, okay, so the Lord said he will bring us into captivity again with ships, all right, and how do we get to the Americas? Cargo slave ships, man, all right, cargo slave ships, he will bring us into Egypt, which, as we know, America's modern day Egypt is spiritually Sodom and Egypt. Okay. All right. And we were taken over here led captive by captors, all right? Not only just Edom, okay, but Edom, you're gonna get it the worst, you know, you're gonna get destroyed completely. But you know, you Africans, you so-called Arabians, you towel heads, you coolies, man, all right. Every nation had the children of Israel in slavery at one point in time, and the Lord is gonna pay y'all back by us having y'all in slavery for 1,000 years, man, to rebuild the kingdom of heaven, all right? And it's going to be way worse than what y'all did to us, man, because we're going to have the spiritual powers then. So we're going to be able to fuck y'all up, man, kill y'all, put y'all right back in your bodies, and do it all over again, man, all right? Y'all are going to really get it, man. Like, and I was basically condemning a Hamite at my job. I was telling him yesterday that, hey, man, you know, you better hope. I called him a kata, and he said, "No, you're a kata." I said, "Hey, man, hey, no, you're gonna be a kata pretty soon." He's like, "How do you know that?" I said, "I read the Bible, and the Bible told me so." All right, and I said, "Hey, man, you know, he said he's from Liberia or something like that." I was like, "All right, hey, you better pray that you're an Israelite, man. Okay, you better pray that you're an Israelite, because if not, you're gonna get fucked up." All right. Long story short, but back to what I was saying, the Lord shall bring thee into Egypt again with ships, by the way whereof I spake unto thee, thou shalt see it no more again. We won't see Israel no more again, man. That's why we're over here in Americas and in different parts of the world, man. All right, and there ye shall be sold unto your enemies for bondmen and bondwomen, and no man shall buy you. All right, hey, we were sold unto our enemies, man. We were putting on our auctioning block, all right, and we were sold, okay? So that's slavery, man, all right? And the Lord, and this is the recompense that y'all are going to get for slavery, because I, like, y'all are so retarded that you think that the Most High and His Son forgot about the apple of His eye, man. All right, you think He's just going to clean the slate of what you did to what you, as in you heathen nations, did to the children of Israel, man. All right, that's retarded, man. All right, Lamentations 4:21-22. Rejoice and be glad, O daughter of Edom. Edom being the Edomites, Esau, aka you so-called Caucasians, all right, you white people that dwellest in the land of Uz. The cup also shall pass through unto thee. Thou shalt be drunken and shalt make thyself naked. That's right. Hey, that cup that we're drinking up of, that, you know, you can read about in Deuteronomy, the 28th chapter, starting at the 14th, 15th verse. Okay, that's being pushed over to you, Edomites, all right, and ultimately, you know, part of that cup was slavery, so you're going into slavery, Edom, all right, 22, the punishment of thine iniquity is accomplished, O daughter of Zion, he will no more carry thee away into captivity, he will visit thine iniquity, O daughter of Edom, he will discover thy sins. So all you Caucasians and you so-called white people that think that the Most High forgot about slavery and it's not going to repay you back for what you've done for hundreds of years, 400 years to be exact, in this captivity, the most recent captivity that we're still in right now, but even before that, and not just Edom, all the other heathen nations are going to get it too, man. All right, the Lord is not playing. Y'all have a severe judgment coming to y'all, man, and through the Spirit, y'all know that. All right, every time brothers do lessons about this subject, man, you always get them damn keyboard warriors, man. All right, because man, I look at it like this: if something's not true, you're not gonna break your neck, all right, or put forth too much energy to try to prove someone's wrong. Say your name was Joshua, all right, like my name is Joshua. If someone was to say, "Oh, well, that's not your name," I will, you know, like, your mom didn't name you that. I'll be like, okay, you know, I probably would just ignore them, man. All right. But anyway, the punishment of thine iniquity is accomplished, O daughter of Zion. He will no more carry thee away into captivity. He will visit thine iniquity, O daughter of Edom. He will discover thy sins. That's why call on all Yahweh by Shem Yahweh Shah for the comforter, for these holy scriptures, for the Holy Spirit, man. Alright? Because when we read this, man, you know, it should bring you joy, man. It should uplift your spirits, man. Alright? These Edomites are gonna get it. Alright? Not only the Edomites, but every other every other, heathen nation that had us in captivity. All right? But, hey, you know, this is one of my favorite books, Obadiah. Edom's going to get it the worst because they're going to get completely destroyed because the Lord has a controversy with Edom. I'm going to read it. Obadiah 1, the vision of Obadiah, thus saith the Lord Yahweh concerning Edom. We have heard a rumor from the Lord, and an ambassador is sent among the heathen. Arise ye, and let us rise up against her in battle. Okay? Hey, that's talking about Edom. This whole book is condemning you Edomites, Esau, a.k.a. you Caucasians. You dirty, filthy dogs, man. All right? Yeah. And this is I'm going to skip down, and I'm going to get to the point about the Lord paying you back for what you've done to the children of Israel, man. All right? Verse 8, shall I not in that day, saith the Lord, even destroy the wise man out of Edom, and understanding out of the mount of Esau, and that mighty man of Teman shall be dismayed to the end, that every one of the mount of Esau may be cut off by slaughter. But thy bias against thy brother Jacob, which is the Israelites, Israel, which Jacob's name was later changed to Israel, shall shame shall cover thee, and thou shalt be cut off forever. Alright, the Lord is going to destroy the spirit of all Edomites after y'all serve out y'all 1,000 years of slavery, man. In the day that thou stoodest on the other side, in the day that the strangers carried away captive his forces, and foreigners entered into his gates, and cast lots upon Jerusalem, even thou wast as one of them. Okay, hey man, that's summing up all of the nations, man. Alright, nations having us in captivity, alright, casting lots upon Jerusalem, man, alright. Jerusalem, Israel, man. 12. But thou shouldest not have looked on the day of thy brother in the day that he became a stranger. Neither should have thou have rejoiced over the children of Judah in the day of their destruction. Neither shall thou have spoken proudly in the day of distress. All right. Thou should have not have entered into the gate of my people. All right. The Israelites in the day of their calamity. Because we were going through various captivities because we were going off, man. We were breaking the law, statutes, commandments of Yahweh, Hashem, Yahweh Shah. Okay? But y'all added more to that, man. Yeah. Thou shouldest not have looked on their affliction in the day of their calamity, nor had laid hands on their substance in the day of their calamity. Okay? We were getting punished, but y'all made it that much worse, man. Neither should thou have stood in the crossway to cut off those of his that did escape. Neither should thou have delivered up those of his that did remain in the day of his distress. For the day of the Lord is near upon all the heathen. All the heathen, man. You Africans, you so-called white people, which is Edom. You Ishmael, all right, Elam, all right, Moab, Ammon, all right, you so-called Chinese and Japanese. All y'all are going to get it, man. As thou hast done, it shall be done unto thee. Thy reward shall return upon thine own head. That's right. Hey, so all this shit that you've done to the Israelites, all right, it's gonna return upon thine own head, man. Call on Yahweh Hashem Yahweh Shah for being the just power that he is, man. Okay? I'm gonna close it out with this script, man. Even King David was prophesying about the downfall of you heathens, man. More so Edom, okay? Remember, O Lord, this is Psalms 137, verse 7 through 9. Remember, O Lord, the children of Edom in the day of Jerusalem, who said, raise it, even to the foundation thereof. And that word raise it means destroy it. Destroy, all right? O daughter of Babylon, who art to be destroyed, okay? Happy shall he be that rewardeth thee as thou hast served us. Happy shall he be that taketh and dasheth thy little ones against the stones. Ooh, okay? That's beautiful, man, because all the atrocities that you've done, all the wicked shit that you've done to the Israelites in slavery, it's going to return upon your own head. You used to dash our little ones against the stones. Y'all used to test y'all might by ripping babies in half, cutting pregnant Israelite women open. Okay, hey, we're going to do that 10 times more, man, okay? And that's beautiful, man. Call Lord Yahweh Hashem Yahweh Shah. Hopefully this is edifying, man. Want to give all honor, praise, and glory. Call Halayim Yahweh Hashem Yahweh Shah. Double honors to the elders and apostles of the great millstone. And salutations, peace, and blessings to the elect Akim, pushing his word in all truth and sincerity, man. Until next time, Shalom.